welcome back to Team Wild Gear. Or actually, welcome back to Team Wild's unboxing of incredibly cool gear. Now, behind me you can see my Merkel RX Helix super fast straight pull rifle in 30.06, wearing its Leica Magnus 1.5 to 10x42 Uberscope. Now, this is the gear I'm taking with me wild boar, driven wild boar hunting in the Czech Republic. But seeing as I was using a Leica scope, I thought, well, I might as well use Leica binos. So the guys at York Guns sent me this. Leica's Geovid 10x42 range-finding binos. Now, I love range-finding binos. A, because I don't have to take a separate range-finder, and B, it's just easier and more intuitive to look through your binos, ranging targets, either the target you're going to shoot at, or a bush, or extra cover. You can help tactically meander your way towards a quarry. And they come in an incredibly shiny silver box, so it must be good, right? Let's have a look inside. Okay, so as you can expect, very pretty packaging. There's a tray in here that has instruction manual in 78 different languages. What I like to see is this. It's a quality control certificate that was made out by a human, not by a robot. The warranty card. This looks like some kind of feedback form. The objective lens caps, really, really useful. Save yourself a lot of wiping lenses. Small battery, Duracell battery for the range-finding unit. Eyepiece covers, and then the obligatory Leica neck strap. Now, chances are I won't be using this. I like to use my bino harness, or my man bra, as it's otherwise known. And then here, this is where they keep the good stuff. So putting the shiny box aside, this is a nice case, so have a look at it now, because the chances of you ever seeing this again are very, very slim. I just don't use my case. So let's open this up. And in here we have, wow. Now, one of the most stylishly built optical instruments I think I've ever seen. Now, Leica do make cameras. They are famous for making stylish and sophisticated looking camera equipment, and these binos here I think follow that same sort of plan. Now, immediately I'm thinking, yeah, they look nice, but do they fit on my hands? And I would say I'm pretty used to using. Now, let me get my Zeiss binos to give you a comparison. Now, these are my Zeiss 10x45s. These are the things I've lived with in the bush for about 3 years now. Super rock solid. I've thrown them in places I shouldn't have done, really, dropped them, crawled in them, dented them, and they still work absolutely perfectly. So with the eyepieces fully extended, that's roughly what we play with. Now, as you can see, these look more stylish, but they're a lot more angular. So there is your like for like. Leica, Zeiss, 10x45, 10x42. So they're not too dissimilar. The Leicas weigh in at 950 grams, so just under a kilo. The Zeiss, 995. The Zeiss has finger grooves here and a more intuitive button placement, I would say, for where my hands go. But what I love about the Leica ones is this button here is long, and there is only one. The amount of times I've played on the right-hand side with my Zeiss and I've changed the menu settings and it's been thoroughly annoying, but this button does fit in the right place. So, turning them round, we can see the underneath here. You can set different focal lengths for your eyes. You can adjust those, and it's very clearly easy to see which, the red on the right and then the white on the left. Now, these are inset, these adjusters, so it's highly unlikely that you're going to accidentally knock them when you're using them out in the field. A couple of little thumb grooves there. If you open them right up, you should just be able to see in there. That's where the housing where the battery goes. Just undo that. Probably undo it with my thumb to start with and then slot the battery in. Now, the extendable eyepieces here are actually really nice. They zoom straight out. They've got kind of an indexing. One, two, three, two, yeah, three different settings depending on your eye relief. But once again, a thoroughly attractive as well as functional packet. Now, who's to know how these perform? I can only let you know in a couple of weeks' time. So there we have it, the Leica Geovid 10x42s. They look very stylish. There's a couple of other exciting bits to them or features that you might be interested in. Firstly, they'll work down to minus 25. Now, it sounds pretty cold, but I was at minus 40 in BC last year, and I was glad that the equipment I had been tested to those sorts of conditions. Now, I don't think the minus 25 is a limitation on the product itself. I think it's probably more likely to be the battery, because at minus 25, a lot of batteries do freeze up. It's also waterproof down to 5 meters. Now, clearly, we're not going to be using it underwater unless I'm really unlucky and lose my footing. But that means that it will withstand the weight and the pressure of water on the joints, so you're not going to get water ingress into the mechanism or into the rangefinder. So that's another really important factor, not just water resistant, but totally waterproof. So compact, stylish, lightweight, packed full of features, and the Aquadura coating on the lenses to keep those clean, dust free, and hopefully free of water. So they're going with me now, along with the Magnus and also the Merkle, and we'll let you know in a couple of weeks' time exactly how we got on. See you then. Subscribe to Team Wild TV for the best vermin busting, hunting gear, bow hunting and air gunning videos on YouTube.